So we're here in the Pando Clone. People drive through it, don't even realize they're in the Pando Clone, or we'll get phone calls and people really wondering, what is this Pando Clone? And it's an aspen stand here on the Fish Lake. You have Highway 25 that goes right through the middle of it. The Pando Clone is 106 acres. Scientists say there's an estimated 50,000 trees here in the Pando. The interesting fact about the Pando Clone is that scientists are claiming that it's the largest living organism in the world that has been DNA tested. So there might be other larger organisms, but based on DNA, this is the largest living organism in the world.
The Pando Clone is, as the Latin word frames it, as ice bread. The problem with the Pando Clone, it's not that necessarily that the overstore is dying or some of the clones not doing well, but we're not getting any regeneration to replace those parts that are dying. So from a Forest Service perspective, yeah, that's a problem when there's no regeneration to replace those that die. This behaves in a lot of ways like any other aspen stand. They get old, they die, new stuff comes up to replace the old. And in this case, the old stuff is dying. There's not much new stuff to replace it.
Typically, we would expect aspen stands should be able to regenerate on their own. I've heard it estimated by scientists that this stand could be upwards of 80,000 years old. That's a guess, but it gives us an indication that this stand is very old. And when you see the Pando, there's no regeneration for the most part occurring, and that's not typical of what you would expect from an aspen stand. So that's the problem, is the root systems are not sending up the suckers, or if they are, they're not having success in being able to grow into mature trees to perpetuate itself. Yeah, so that's why we're doing this study. We have a theory that herbivory is playing a role in it. As the plants come up, they're grazing or browsing the plants off. And so that's one reason. Another thought is that the Pando is just old and doesn't have the energy reserves to send up suckering. Other ideas are that it has fungus, and that a type of fungus that's causing its problems. Just one other item too is that aspen stands like disturbance. When they're disturbed through fire, mechanical, different types of treatments, they regenerate. And so those are the things that we're looking at with the Pando Clone to try to figure out why it's not regenerating as well as it should on its own. The fence that we've placed around portions of the Pando Clone, there's 106 acres and we've fenced off approximately 90 acres of it to remove the browsing issue, the cattle and the deer, and to be able to see what role that was playing in this. Then we can compare it to areas that are not fenced off and get a better feel for the browsing part of it.
So the fence was to address the grazers. So as you know, when you run some scientific tests, you try to eliminate some things so you can get a better or a more accurate reading on what that test is. So I think what we're going to find as we do some of these studies in here, that it's although the grazers may play a role in it, they're not the only thing that's causing the decline. There were different varieties of beetles, borers. Some of these trees here with the black on them and whatnot are caused by a bacterial infection. When we had our insect and disease specialist here, she suspects this is what's called shepherd's crook. It's caused by a fungus that's affecting the regeneration, or at least the top leader. Top leader would be something like this. This is your top leader. So it affects it, comes down to about this point here on the tree, causes the top to bend over like this, called a shepherd's crook. So some of that is going on in here. Not affecting all the regeneration, but some. So there's a prescribed burn. Removal of a juniper, which the suspicion there is that the common juniper that you're seeing here competes with and or can outcompete regeneration. And then the third one was selective cutting to remove some of the overstory to promote suckering. So those are the three things that we're trying right now, and we'll see how that shakes out. This is likely a regeneration response from the burn that was done in the spring of the year.
Like all aspen stands, they function as clones. So they reproduce by suckering. So the root system under the ground is all one family, or they all are of the same DNA makeup. And so that's how all aspen stands are. A clone all looks the same, basically. When they leaf out in the spring, they do it at the same time. And as you look across the landscape, you'll see one clone leaving, another clone next to it not leaving. In the fall, when they change colors, the clone will typically look the same and then be different than another clone right next to it. So you can, just by looking at a clone, kind of begin to say, you know, that's an aspen clone in itself. Certainly aspen is an important plant community and species that we have on the Fish Lake and on most of our forests. We look at the aspen as a keystone species for what they provide, you know, on the landscape. Aspen, they're highly productive areas. They have high diversity in plant and animal life. They're important to our watersheds. And so as managers and as scientists, we want to understand how aspen function so that we can make good decisions in the way that we preserve and utilize our aspen stands. And because Pando was assigned a name and people have taken interest, we decided on the Fish Lake that it was important that we preserve the Pando clone and try to better understand how it functions and also to understand the problems that the Pando is having. I think that that's a role that we have as land managers, to be mindful of the uniqueness of this area and to try to sustain it.
The goal, obviously, is to maintain the Pando clone. And from my perspective, that's always meant not just maintaining it for us here, but our kids and their kids, because the mission of the Forest Service is to maintain these types of things as well as the rest of the forest for future generations, not just for ourselves. So that's my hope and goal. We'll see if we're successful.